Now, tensions between India and Pakistan have been simmering since the February 14th attack in Jammu and Kashmir. India has made it very clear that terror and talks cannot go hand in hand. My colleague Karthikeya Sharma spoke to BJP's Jammu and Kashmir in charge Ram Madhav on the issue. Here's an excerpt from that interview.
Tell me, Ram Madhav ji, in retrospect, was it correct of BJP to get into an alliance with PDP? There's so much of bitterness and acrimony today.
Look, alliances, we have, I mean, it's not for the first time that we have entered into any alliance in 2015. You have seen our we supporting VP Singh. So much criticism was there. We had a lot of bitter experiences after the alliance with VP Singh, in the VP Singh government when we supported them. We had experiences and experiences. Alliances are made depending on the current situation, current compulsions of political or electoral compulsions of the state, given situation. Sometimes they work well, sometimes they don't. Many people refer to Shiv Sena BJP relationship, very long relationship, but it has had its own ups and downs. We contested assembly elections independently. We did not go together. So alliances are all, after all, altogether a different ball game. You are asking specifically about PDP. There was a peculiar situation in Jammu and Kashmir whereby we were compelled, we both parties were compelled to come together to respect the mandate given by the people. Valley voted for PDP, Jammu voted for BJP. Without these two parties coming together, no government was possible. We tried to work together for 3 years. We have achieved many things. We could not achieve a few things, but a point came where we felt that our larger national vision is getting affected due to this one alliance. We walked out.
You know, Mufti Saab used to say that this is the way to get Jammu and Kashmir together.
Precisely.
But situation deteriorated in the valley. Why did that happen?
Lofty, very large objective was that greater unity within the state, leading to greater integration of the state with the rest of the country. We have achieved a lot of progress in that, but the situation in the valley, as far as valley situation is concerned, I don't want to link it to any given government alone. When you can't blame a 2 year or 3 year BJP or PDP government for what is happening in the valley today. This has been a problem going on for many decades now. Now, for example, for last 10 months, there was no government. There is no government in the state. Still, we are seeing problems. Still, we are seeing terrorism. Still, we are seeing ghastly incidents happening because the root of this problem is elsewhere. You have to tackle the separatist terrorist elements in the state sternly, but also you have to tackle your neighbor. Today, thanks to Modi ji, we are able to do both the things. I'm sure in next few months' time, things will definitely improve. And in fact, that could be one of the reasons why the Election Commission has decided not to go for the assembly elections now and wait for some more time.
But your critics say that globally the insurgencies are always resolved through talks, political actions. And globally it has happened. And the criticism is that talk within the valley has not taken place. Yes, you have responded. Surgical strike has taken place. Balakot has happened. You have hit at Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. But the talks has not taken place inside. Why?
I don't know who say that globally insurgencies, terrorism is tackled through talks. Terrorism is first tackled militarily in a very tough way. After that part is done, then talks happen. Not the other way. You hold a gun and you force me to talk. That's not the way in which we believe. If you are interested in talks, if the terrorists or separatists are interested in talks, Home Minister has given a carte blanche to them. Last year, if you remember, Home Minister has announced that the government is open to talking to anybody. But the other side was not ready for talks. They wanted to persist with terrorism. Globally, wherever there is terror, there you find governments acting tough. You have seen in Afghanistan, you have seen in other countries. What you are seeing in Pakistan today, although it is half-hearted thing or whatever, you know, it happened in many countries, but each country has its own way of dealing with it. You know, in India also, we always dealt with them sternly, whether it is Maoist, insurgent, irrespective of which government is in power. I lived in Andhra Pradesh for many years. I have seen Congress governments, TDP, NT Rama Rao's government acting very tough with the Maoists.